Let us start with the Oracle Sourcing Superuser Guide. We'll see all the functions inside the sourcing module, what the superuser can do. So there are certain, so there are different type of functions which has given to different type of roles in Oracle Sourcing module. So we'll go to the application and we'll see the things there. So I will log in the application. So this is the main page for Oracle EBS. So I will navigate to Oracle Sourcing Superuser, responsibility, and then it goes to the sourcing, and I will navigate to the sourcing homepage. Now, while the moment you click on sourcing homepage, this is a page which appears in front of you, which is a sourcing homepage page, main page. On the top, you have the requisition tab. By default, it goes to the negotiations tab. Intelligence tab is there and administration is there. So we'll go one by one and we'll see all the details and the functions inside it. The first thing is searching the published negotiations, means those RFQs which is approved and published. So in that case, if super user want to place up the number over here, he can search by placing up the number, or he can search by the title, he can search by the line description, he can search by event, he can search by created by, who is working on that particular RFQ, he can search by the supplier. So this is different searching criteria to search the RFQ. So the moment you place the number or any of these fields, it will show you the information down. Now, what is the information which is coming down? It is the RFQ numbers. Again, now these RFQ numbers are system generated numbers, so you can click on them and it will navigate to the next level. I mean, it will go to the details of this particular RFQ. We have the title of this RFQ, for what is the purpose of this RFQ, what is the type, how much time left, what is the close date, how many responses are there for this particular RFQ, means how many supplier have submitted their quotations for this particular RFQ. So quotation submission from the suppliers are counted as responses over here. What is status? It's active and logged. Who is working on it? Who created it? And then we have the column with the name of unread messages. I mean, you can see what are the online discussions happens between internally between the collaboration team members or between the suppliers and the buyer. So this is the detail of searching the RFQs. So you can have, you can see all the details of all the RFQs and this and the status of it. Let me navigate back to the negotiation. We'll see the other thing which is on this page. Now this portion is saying approved and published sourcing RFQs. So this page or this table will display those RFQs which is assigned to that particular buyer and he's working on it, and they are approved and published. So they can, he can, the person can see, or the buyer can see the RFQ number, he can see the RFQ title, type, definitely it will be RFQ or it can be an RFI also. So time left, how much time left, he is the member or the owner of that particular RFQ, so a role will be displayed over here. How many responses from suppliers he received, two responses, three responses, based on the number of suppliers he invited. So you can monitor, system is giving you a graphical view of monitoring the RFQ performance, that how many, how much was the value, how many suppliers quoted, which one goes better. So a very low level, or you can say a very brief level kind of monitor live console is there. And we have the unread messages column over here, so he can see what are the messages over there for this particular RFQ, and he can see a message, a value inside this column once a message arrives to him. Down we have some quick links where you can have certain functions, you can create these documents, you can manage certain things, you can make templates to be used, you can make the use of reusable list. So what are those? We'll go and we'll see it. Creating the RFI, so the person, super user or a buyer, he can make an RFI and he can float an RFI for which the procedure remains the same. The number is system generated number, so he can place up the suppliers, or he can place the suppliers to be invited in this particular RFQ to get the responses from him. This is RFI, so you can make the RFI directly. As per standard, the PR cannot be converted to RFI. Next part is the RFQ. So you can create an RFQ in which currently all the PRs which is assigned to the buyers, they are used to be converted from PR to RFQ. So this is the RFQ creation. You can copy the copy function, which help you to copy the RFQ which is there. Anything, any line, any complete information you want to copy from that previous RFQ, you can copy from that RFQ or RFI. And the last thing is the event. So you can create an event and to be attached with the RFQ or RFI. The next part is the managing. Now managing IR basically a function which helps you to manage your drafts, to manage those things which is in process, means it's not being submitted for approval and it is still you are working on it. The managing draft means managing that those RFQs which are in draft mode, means you are working on it. So in that particular case, you can, because you can save the RFQ at any point of time, so you can save the RFQ, get the system generated number out of it, and then you can use this feature to update that particular RFQ. Events, you can create the event, as I said, so you can create the events and you can attach the events, so you can manage the events also. Next thing is the deliverables. Now deliverables are those documents which needs to be delivered from the supplier side. Like in case of RFQ, the deliverables are, for that particular deliver the RFQ, the deliverables can be CR certificate, any legal document you require from the supplier side to be submitted while submitting the quotation with this particular RFQ. The deliverables can be managed and can be attached with your RFQ. So once the supplier will quote, he will place he will be able to see all the deliverables which is needed to be submitted along with that particular RFQ quotation. So these are the deliverables. So you can maintain your deliverables, that these are the deliverables which is arrived from the suppliers. Next is the drafting of surrogate responses. Is basically giving a chance, a special feature to the buyer to create a quotation on behalf of supplier. So in this case, the system is giving an option that you can create a draft response. You can create the quotation on behalf of supplier and place it in the system so that you can analyze and you can award the business to the respective supplier. Then the next part is the templates. You can make RFI template, you can make RFQ templates, you can make an auction template. So these are the templates, means includes those information which is fixed. So those information which are fixed can be used for creating a template. So what you need to do is that you can make different type of templates for different nature of the RFQs, like maintenance RFQs, like a heavy equipment RFQ. So you can have different type of templates to be placed over there, and you can fix up the details inside this RFQ. Now what are the details you can place it inside it? Let's have a look to the template which we have. I will search it out for you. So this is one of the template which we have created over there. If I will click on it, what it will show me, the details which I place inside it. Okay, so this is just an information I'm showing you, that I can place up the collaboration team members. So every time I will just apply it and it will bring up the collaboration team members automatically over there, instead of every time I will create an RFQ and I will place it up. Next is the requirements. So you can, I can make different sections and I can place different type of questions to be asked from the supplier, so that once I apply this particular template to an RFQ, the supplier will be able to see and respond. So such as, like over here we have these questions and this is a target to it. So supplier can answer to these questions while he is replying to this RFQ as a quotation. So similarly, you can place up different set of requirements over here instead of placing it one by one. Next is, if you scroll to the line defaults, these are some of the generic kind of attributes of an item you can place up in the system, where this the supplier has to answer all these things or all these values when he is replying to the RFQ by making his quotation and by filling up these values for particular line item for which it is asked. So you can fix up the line defaults, you can place up the attributes over there, you can also fix up the controls, how you want to control the RFQ. So these are some response rules over here. And if you want to create or place the suppliers over here, you can place up the suppliers also. in the RFQ template. So every time you just apply this template on the, on your particular RFQ, and it will inherit all the information from this RFQ on from this RFQ template on your actual RFQ, and it will shorten your time to process one single RFQ and send it for the approvals. So this is the major function of the template. So let us go back and we'll see the others. Similarly, we have the RFI, and we can, you can make the auction template. So the idea remains the same. The next part is the reusable list. Now, reusable list are those lists which is used frequently, like invitation list. Now, invitation list is what? Is that you can place up, or you can make different type of invitation list in the system based on the item category or item type. For example, IT equipment supplier. This is one of the type. This is a list name. So IT equipment supplier can have all the suppliers who provides IT equipments. So in this case, I can have multiple reusable invitation list, which I can place it in the system. So every time when I will make an RFQ, instead of adding the suppliers one by one, it's better I will use that particular invitation list and just attach it. So it will take some seconds for me or some minutes to just place up all like 10 to 15 set of suppliers in a single shot on your RFQ. So it will make your life easier. The next part is the attributes. Now, the attributes idea is that attributes are always concerned and respective to an item. The attribute of a medical equipment is always different from the attribute of a laptop. So in this case, you have different type of attributes. So you can place up the attribute list. You can define multiple attribute list in the system so that you can place and attach these attribute list in your RFQ and you can use them. Requirements. What are the requirements? Requirements are basically the set of sections and the questions you want to ask supplier. As we have seen, so requirements are that this supplier, for how many years he is there in the market, for how many years he has experience of this product, for how many resources he have to give the support for that particular equipment, and all these things. So these are certain type of generic questions which you can ask, and you can place it up in your particular RFQ when you are making any type of RFQ. So there can be different type of set of questions you can place based on different type of conditions. Like you can make one section for the local suppliers, you can have another section for the foreign suppliers. So you can use these two different sections to place up different set of questions over there. So once you have these requirement list defined over there, you can use them in the RFQ and it will be added automatically. So in this case, it will also make your life easier. You don't need to add the requirements and the sections one by one in your RFQ. You can define different type of requirement list and place in your RFQ template and apply this template on your actual RFQ. So it will be inherited automatically from your RFQ template. And the next is the cost factor. The cost factor can be of two types. It can be a buyer cost factor or a supplier cost factor. So you can define different type of cost factors, like custom duty charges. There are certain charges which is fixed from the buyer side. So you can place up those cost factors values which is fixed from the buyer side. You can hide it from the supplier side also. But there are some cost factor which you want the supplier to enter the details of it. For example, I'm buying a laptop from a supplier. The laptop price it should have the shipping charges also with it. So this is a supplier charge, it's not a buyer charge. So in this particular thing, the supplier charges, I will give a option to a supplier that while he is quoting for that particular RFQ, do place the actual price of a laptop plus what are the shipping charges for that particular laptop. So this is a cost factor of a supplier type. So you can manage different type of cost factors, and you can attach it with, again, directly with the RFQ, or place it up in your RFQ template and apply this template to your actual RFQ. So these are the major, the functions of the quick links which Oracle Sourcing module supports. On your right hand side, you will always see a draft negotiation, if draft negotiation over there. So those negotiations which is in a draft mode means the person is working on it, still it is in process, it's not being sent for the approval, will display on your right hand side over here. The moment it is published, it will display over here in this table. So now, like this one, the one which you are seeing over here, it's a draft negotiation. So let us see what is there inside it. Okay. So this is the header page of an RFQ. So to create an RFQ, the system is giving on the top the RFQ number is there. So you can place up all the details inside it. You can notify the members, the collaboration team members, or by selecting all of them and by clicking on the notify button. So it means once you add up any of the collaboration team member, he will be notified by a notification to his email and also in the EBS that he is the part of this particular RFQ, so that you can do online discussions with that particular collaboration team member. The next is the terms and the terms. You can place the terms over there. Next part is the requirements. As I was explaining, you can either, now I need to place the requirements by myself, which is one by one, or I will place it in the template and apply this template on this RFQ. So let us see what is applied. So I have applied the template over here, and it is showing me two set of sections, which is the general requirements for the local RFQ and general requirements for the foreign RFQ. So if I want to see what are the questions inside it, I will just click on the plus sign. It will show me those are the questions which I place in the RFQ and needs to be answered by the supplier while he is quoting for this particular RFQ. Going down, we have the notes and attachments. If the person who is working on this particular RFQ, we want to place any note to the supplier as a generic note, he can place a note to the supplier. He can make an attachment also over here. You can save your RFQ at any point of time. So save as draft button is coming over here on all the pages. You can do the online discussion at this point of time also with all these members internally. And once you have the suppliers, you can do the online discussions with the suppliers also. Now clicking on the lines over here, it will display you the lines inherited from your purchase acquisition, because all the buyers, they will take up their assigned PRs, and these PRs will be later on converted to the RFQ. So you will see the lines having a relationship with the purchase acquisition automatically. Next is the controls. So these are the controls for this particular RFQ. You can place the close date, open date for this particular RFQ. So I'm just, for example, placing up the date over here. The preview date should be immediately, open date when it is going to be open, and award date if you mention it's an optional thing. Response rules, these are the response rules over here, that how you want this RFQ to be handled. Contract terms. Now these contract terms are those terms and conditions which you will place, or you want to attach with this particular RFQ. Either it's a local RFQ, or it's a foreign RFQ, or it's a mixed kind of an RFQ. You can place your terms and conditions over here with certain set of deliverables that once the supplier respond, he will respond to based on, by agreeing to these terms and conditions and by these deliverables. So you can place up the details over here. Like now you are able to see the contract template which is coming on the top. This is the contract template name. So if I apply the template, it will bring up all the terms and conditions which is there. So I will click on it and I will see. So you will be able to see all the terms and conditions which is there. So this is how it looked like. If I click on the deliverables, it will show me all the deliverables which is also there, which is needs to be submitted with this RFQ against the quotation submitted by the supplier. So we have the set of deliverables over there, and we have the clauses. So he has to agree to those terms and conditions which you have placed over there, and the deliverable he has to place up and supply these deliverables while quoting against this particular RFQ. The next part is the suppliers. Now suppliers, it's as I said, you either it's an invitation list, means you can make an invitation list and you will just add the set of 15, 20, 25 suppliers in one shot by placing an invitation list, or you will click on add supplier and you will start adding supplier. You search a supplier over here, like over here I am searching the supplier. So it will show you the suppliers down. So you will select the supplier, you will add it to the invited suppliers list. So it will display on your right hand side, which is on the top. So this is how you will enter the suppliers to the RFQ. So this is a brief overview of placing up an RFQ in the system, what are the functions of the RFQ, what are the details of the RFQ, and the how you can control the things inside the RFQ. So the very last part is setting up the preferences and plus the administration. So let me just highlight the important thing in the administration is that he can cancel the RFQ. So this is a feature which is only given to the sourcing super user. He can cancel and delete the negotiation by placing up the number over here. You have to cancel the RFQ first and then the deletion will be allowed as per the system intended functionality. This is one of the major thing. And the other thing which I want to highlight is that you can, I mean, here it's negotiation tools are the same as we have seen on the front, making up different type of reusable list, cost factor list. These are the same as we have seen on the first page. The other important thing is the preference. If you want to set up the preferences, you can just scroll down and place up the preferences that what is your default start page. So you can place up the start page over here and the notification. So email style notification will be sent to your current default language, whatever it is, either you placed Arabic, English or whatsoever. So you have to select the HTML mail with the attachments as an option so that the suppliers, so that once the emails are because the notification mailer is sending the emails from the system, so when auto generated email fires from an application, you will receive in your notification in the system plus in your respective emails. So this is the very last option for that particular sourcing module. Let me click back on the home. Okay, and this is all about the sourcing page, which will look like this. So this is the brief overview of regarding sourcing module. Thank you very much. Let us start with the Oracle Sourcing Super User Guide. We'll see all the functions inside the sourcing module, what the super user can do. And so there are different type of functions which has given to different type of roles in Oracle Sourcing module. So we'll go to the application and we'll see the things there. So I will log in the application. So this is the main page for Oracle EBS. So I will navigate to Oracle Sourcing Super User Responsibility, and then it goes to the sourcing, and I will navigate to the sourcing homepage. Now, the moment you click on sourcing homepage, this is a page which appears in front of you, which is a sourcing homepage main page. On the top, you have the requisition tab. By default, it goes to the negotiations tab. Intelligence tab is there, and administration is there. So we'll go one by one, we'll see all the details and the functions inside it. The first thing is searching the published negotiations, means those RFQs which is approved and published. So in that case, if super user want to place up the number over here, he can search by placing up the number, or he can search by the title, he can search by the line description, he can search by event, he can search by created by, who is working on that particular RFQ, he can search by the supplier. So this is different searching criteria to search the RFQ. So the moment you place the number or any of these fields, it will show you the information down. Now, what is the information which is coming down? It is the RFQ numbers. Again, now these RFQ numbers are system generated numbers, so you can click on them and it will navigate to the next level. I mean, it will go to the details of this particular RFQ. We have the title of this RFQ, for what is the purpose of this RFQ, what is the type, how much time left, what is the close date, how many responses are there for this particular RFQ, means how many supplier have submitted their quotations for this particular RFQ. So quotation submission from the suppliers are counted as responses over here. What is status? It's active and logged. Who is working on it? Who created it? And then we have the column with the name of unread messages. I mean, you can see what are the online discussions happens internally between the collaboration team members or between the suppliers and the buyer. So this is the detail of searching the RFQs. So you can have, you can see all the details of all the RFQs and this and the status of it. Let me navigate back to the negotiation. We'll see the other thing which is on this page. Now this portion is saying approved and published sourcing RFQs. So this page or this table will display those RFQs which is assigned to that particular buyer and he's working on it, and they are approved and published. So they can, he can, the person can see, or the buyer can see the RFQ number, he can see the RFQ title, type, definitely it will be RFQ or it can be an RFI also. So time left, how much time left, he is the member or the owner of that particular RFQ, so a role will be displayed over here. How many responses from suppliers he received, two responses, three responses based on the number of suppliers he invited. So you can monitor, system is giving you a graphical view of monitoring the RFQ performance, that how many, how much was the value, how many suppliers quoted, which one goes better. So a very very low level, or you can say a very brief level kind of monitor live console is there. And we have the red unread messages column over here, so he can see what are the messages over there for this particular RFQ, and he can see a message, a value inside this column once a message arrives to him. Down we have some quick links where you can have certain functions, you can create these documents, you can manage certain things, you can make templates to be used, you can make the use of reusable list. So what are those, we'll go and we'll see it. Creating the RFI, so the person, super user or a buyer, he can make an RFI and he can float an RFI for which the procedure remains the same, the number is system generated number, so he can place up the suppliers or he can place the suppliers to be invited in this particular RFQ to get the responses from him. This is RFI, so you can make the RFI directly. As per standard, the PR cannot be converted to RFI. Next part is the RFQ. So you can create an RFQ in which currently all the PRs which is assigned to the buyers, they are used to be converted from PR to RFQ. So this is the RFQ creation. You can copy, the copy function which help you to copy the RFQ which is there. Anything, any line, any complete information you want to copy from that previous RFQ, you can copy from that RFQ or RFI. And the last thing is the event, so you can create an event and to be attached with the RFQ or RFI. The next part is the managing. Now managing IR basically a function which helps you to manage your drafts, to manage those things which is in process, means it's not being submitted for approval and it is still you are working on it. The managing draft means managing that, those RFQs which are in draft mode, means you are working on it. So in that particular case, you can, because you can save the RFQ at any point of time, so you can save the RFQ, get the system generated number out of it, and then you can use this feature to update that particular RFQ. Events, you can create the event, as I said, so you can create the events and you can attach the event, so you can manage the events also. Next thing is the deliverables. Now deliverables are those documents which needs to be delivered from the supplier side. Like in case of RFQ, the deliverables are, for that particular deliver the RFQ, the deliverables can be CR certificate, any legal document you require from the supplier side to be submitted while submitting the quotation with this particular RFQ, the deliverables can be managed and can be attached with your RFQ. So once the supplier will quote, he will place he will be able to see all the deliverables which is needed to be submitted along with that particular RFQ quotation. So these are the deliverables, so you can maintain your deliverables, that these are the deliverables which is arrived from the suppliers. Next is the drafting of surrogate responses, is basically a giving a chance, a special feature to the buyer to create a quotation on behalf of supplier. So in this case, the system is giving an option that you can create a draft response, you can create the quotation on behalf of supplier and place it in the system so that you can analyze and you can award the business to the respective supplier. Then the next part is the templates. You can make RFI template, you can make RFQ templates, you can make an auction template. So these are the templates, means includes those information which is fixed. So those information which are fixed can be used for creating a template. So what you need to do is that you can make different type of templates for different nature of the RFQs, like maintenance RFQs, like a heavy equipment RFQ. So you can have different type of templates to be placed over there, and you can fix up the details inside this RFQ. Now what are the details? You can place it inside it. Let's have a look to the template which we have. It's the, I will search it out for you. So this is one of the template which we have created over there. If I will click on it, what it will show me, the details which I place inside it. Okay, so this is just an information I'm showing you, that I can place up the collaboration team members. So every time I will just apply it, and it will bring up the collaboration team members automatically over there, instead of every time I will create an RFQ and I will place it up. Next is the requirements. So you can, I can make different sections, and I can place different type of questions to be asked from the supplier, so that once I apply this particular template to an RFQ, the supplier will be able to see and respond. So such as, like over here we have these questions and this is a target to it. So supplier can answer to these questions while he is replying to this RFQ as a quotation. So similarly, you can place up different set of requirements over here instead of placing it one by one. Next is, if you scroll to the line defaults, these are some of the generic kind of attributes of an item you can place up in the system, where this idea, the supplier has to answer all these things or all these values when he is replying to the RFQ by making his quotation and by filling up these values for particular line item for which it is asked. So you can fix up the line defaults, you can place up the attributes over there, you can also fix up the controls, how you want to control the RFQ. So these are some response rules over here. And if you want to create or place the suppliers over here, you can place up the suppliers also in the RFQ template. So every time you just apply this template on your particular RFQ, and it will inherit all the information from this RFQ from this RFQ template on your actual RFQ, and it will shorten your time to process one single RFQ and send it for the approvals. So this is the major function of the template. So let us go back and we'll see the others. Similarly, we have the RFI, and you can make the auction template. So the idea remains the same. The next part is the reusable list. Now reusable list are those lists which is used frequently, like invitation list. Now invitation list is what? Is that you can place up or you can make different type of invitation list in the system based on the item category or item type. For example, IT equipment supplier. This is one of the type. This is a list name. So IT equipment supplier can have all the suppliers who provides IT equipments. So in this case, I can have multiple reusable invitation list, which I can place it in the system. So every time when I will make an RFQ, instead of adding the suppliers one by one, it's better I will use that particular invitation list and just attach it. So it will take some seconds for me or some minutes to just place up all like 10 to 15 set of suppliers in a single shot on your RFQ. So it will make your life easier. The next part is the attributes. Now the attributes idea is that attributes are always concerned and respective to an item. The attribute of a medical equipment is always different from the attribute of a laptop. So in this case, you have different type of attributes. So you can place up the attribute list, you can define multiple attribute list in the system, so that you can place and attach these attribute list in your RFQ and you can use them. Requirements. What are the requirements? Requirements are basically the set of sections and the questions you want to ask supplier. As we have seen, so requirements are that this supplier, for how many years he is there in the market, for how many years he has experience of this product, for how many resources he have to give the support for that particular equipment, and all these things. So these are certain type of generic questions which you can ask, and you can place it up in your particular RFQ when you are making any type of RFQ. So there can be different type of set of questions you can place based on different type of conditions. Like you can make one section for the local suppliers, you can have another section for the foreign suppliers. So you can use these two different sections to place a different set of questions over there. So once you have these requirement list defined over there, you can use them in the RFQ and it will be added automatically. So in this case, it will also make your life easier. You don't need to add the requirements and the sections one by one in your RFQ. You can define different type of requirement list and place in your RFQ template and apply this template on your actual RFQ. So it will be inherited automatically from your RFQ template. And the next is the cost factor. The cost factor can be of two types. It can be a buyer cost factor or a supplier cost factor. So you can define different type of cost factors like custom duty charges. There are certain charges which is fixed from the buyer side. So you can place up those cost factors values which is fixed from the buyer side. You can hide it from the supplier side also. But there are some cost factor which you want the supplier to enter the details of it. For example, I'm buying a laptop from a supplier. The laptop price I won't play includes the, or it should have the shipping charges also with it. So this is a supplier charge, it's not a buyer charge. So in this particular thing, the supplier charges, I will give a option to a supplier that while he is quoting for that particular RFQ, do place the actual price of a laptop plus what are the shipping charges for that particular laptop. So this is a cost factor of a supplier type. So you can manage different type of cost factors and you can attach it with, again, directly with the RFQ or place it up in your RFQ template and apply this template to your actual RFQ. So these are the major, the functions of the quick links which Oracle Sourcing module supports. On your right hand side, you will always see a draft negotiation, if draft negotiation over there. So those negotiations which is in a draft mode means the person is working on it, still it is in process. It's not being sent for the approval, will display on your right hand side over here. The moment it is published, it will display over here in this table. So now like this one, the one which you are seeing over here, it's a draft negotiation. So let us see what is there inside it. Okay. So this is the header page of an RFQ. So to create an RFQ, the system is giving on the top the RFQ number is there. So you can place up all the details inside it. You can notify the members, the collaboration team members, or by selecting all of them and by clicking on the notify button. So it means once you add up any of the collaboration team member, he will be notified by a notification to his email and also in the EBS that he is the part of this particular RFQ. So that you can do online discussions with that particular collaboration team member. The next is the terms and the terms. You can place the terms over there. Next part is the requirements. As I was explaining, you can either, now I need to place the requirements by myself, which is one by one, or I will place it in the template and apply this template on this RFQ. So let us see what is applied. So I have applied the template over here and it is showing me two set of sections, which is the general requirements for the local RFQ and general requirements for the foreign RFQ. So if I want to see what are the questions inside it, I will just click on the plus sign. It will show me those are the questions which I place in the RFQ and needs to be answered by the supplier while he is quoting for this particular RFQ. Going down, we have the notes and attachments. If the person who is working on this particular RFQ, we want to place any note to the supplier as a generic note, he can place a note to the supplier. He can make an attachment also over here. You can save your RFQ at any point of time. So save as draft button is coming over here on all the pages. You can do the online discussion at this point of time also with all these members internally. And once you have the suppliers, you can do the online discussions with the suppliers also. Now clicking on the lines over here, it will display you the lines inherited from your purchase acquisition, because all the buyers, they will take up their assigned PRs and these PRs will be later on converted to the RFQ. So you will see the lines having a relationship with the purchase acquisition automatically. Next is the controls. So these are the controls for this particular RFQ. You can place the close date, open date for this particular RFQ. So I'm just, for example, placing up the date over here. The preview date should be immediately. Open date, when it is going to be open, and award date, if you mention it's an optional thing. Response rules, these are the response rules over here, that how you want this RFQ to be handled. Contract terms. Now these contract terms are those terms and conditions which you will place, or you want to attach with this particular RFQ. Either it's a local RFQ, or it's a foreign RFQ, or it's a mix kind of an RFQ. You can place your terms and conditions over here with certain set of deliverables that once the supplier respond, he will respond to based on by agreeing to these terms and conditions and by these deliverables. So you can place up the details over here. Like now you are able to see the contract template which is coming on the top. This is the contract template name. So if I apply the template, it will bring up all the terms and conditions which is there. So I will click on it and I will see. So you will be able to see all the terms and conditions which is there. So this is how it looked like. If I click on the deliverables, it will show me all the deliverables which is also there, which is needs to be submitted with this RFQ against the quotation submitted by the supplier. So we have the set of deliverables over there, and we have the clauses. So he has to agree to those terms and conditions which you have placed over there, and the deliverable he has to place up and supply these deliverables while quoting against this particular RFQ. The next part is the suppliers. Now suppliers, it's as I said, you either it's an invitation list, means you can make an invitation list and you will just add the set of 15, 20, 25 suppliers in one shot by placing a invitation list, or you will click on add supplier and you will start adding supplier. You search the supplier over here. Like over here, I am searching the supplier. So it will show you the suppliers down. So you will select the supplier. You will add it to the invited suppliers list. So it will display on your right hand side, which is on the top. So this is how you will enter the suppliers to the RFQ. So this is a brief overview of placing up an RFQ in the system. What are the functions of the RFQ? What are the details of the RFQ, and how you can control the things inside the RFQ? So the very last part is setting up the preferences and plus the administration. So let me just highlight the important thing in the administration is that he can cancel the RFQ. So this is a feature which is only given to the sourcing super user. He can cancel and delete the negotiation by placing up the number over here. You have to cancel the RFQ first and then the deletion will be allowed as per the system intended functionality. This is one of the major thing, and the other thing which I want to highlight is that you can, I mean, here it's a negotiation tools are the same as we have seen on the front, making up different type of reusable list, cost factor list. These are the same as we have seen on the first page. The other important thing is the preference. If you want to set up the preferences, you can just scroll down and place up the preferences that what is your default start page. So you can place up the start page over here, and the notification. So email style notification will be sent to your current default language, whatever it is, either you placed Arabic, English or whatsoever. So you have to select the HTML mail with the attachments as an option, so that the suppliers, so that even once the emails are because the notification mailer is sending the emails from the system, so when auto generated email fires from an application, you will receive in your notification in the system plus in your respective emails. So this is the very last option for that particular sourcing module. Let me click back on the home. Okay, and this is all about the sourcing page, which will look like this. So this is the brief overview regarding sourcing module. Thank you very much.